In this video, we address the ancillary services in microgrids, which are provided during the islanded mode. The main learning objectives will fall under three main questions. Firstly, what are the most important electricity services for the microgrids during the islanded mode? Secondly, how the frequency and voltage support are provided during the islanded operation mode? Thirdly, what is the islanding process? When a microgrid is disconnected from the external grid, the frequency and voltage are not obviously controlled anymore by the grid. Therefore, alternatively, one or more electrical components are required to take over the control of frequency and voltage in microgrid. In this video, we try to address the ancillary services related to the frequency and voltage control in microgrids during the islanded operation. Also, we address the islanding process from the grid connected to the islanded mode. As it is shown in the figure, the frequency remains stable at 50 Hz when there is a balance between the loads on the left-hand side and the generation on the right-hand side. If the total power generation is higher than the loads, then the frequency starts to increase, and vice versa. The frequency can be controlled by various generating units or the loads in microgrids. Diesel engines are able to control the frequency, particularly during the emergency conditions, as a backup. If the amount of the available fuel for the diesel engine would be high, then they can continue with the islanded operation for a long period of time, for instance, for several days or weeks. Moreover, batteries are able to control the frequency mainly through their power electronic converters. The duration of the islanded operation by the batteries will obviously depend on their size and the level of the load consumption in the microgrid, as discussed in detail in the second week. The loads can be also controlled and managed in such a way that the frequency is better supported in microgrids. Note that electrical loads are not obviously able to independently maintain the frequency, while the diesel engines and batteries are able to keep the frequency stable during the standalone mode. Let's now discuss the frequency control in an islanded microgrid for two types of disturbances. Firstly, the case in which a number of generating units are disconnected from an islanded microgrid. Secondly, an islanded microgrid in which a number of loads are disconnected. While the first disturbance will create an under-frequency event, the second one will lead to an over-frequency event. In the next slides, we will analyze the frequency response, which will be shown on the y-axis at the time that is shown in the x-axis. Let's discuss the first case for the under-frequency event. In the figure, at the beginning, the frequency is controlled almost around the nominal value in the islanded microgrid. However, some moments later, a number of generating units are disconnected, due to which the frequency starts to decrease. As we had discussed in the previous weeks and also during the MATLAB simulink assignments, the rate of change of frequency, ROCOF, in the islanded microgrid depends on the amount of the inertia as well as the implementation of the inertia emulation loops. If the frequency can be maintained within the limits, then the islanded microgrid will be under the safe operation where no additional control action is needed. However, if the frequency decreases below a certain limit, F min 1, then a fraction of the loads are to be shed to control the frequency. This is the first threshold for the implementation of the under-frequency load shedding. According to various standards, this fraction of the load might vary from 5% to 25%. If the first load shedding action would not be effective enough to stop the frequency drop, then another load shedding steps might be applied. When the frequency decreases below the second limit, F min 2, then an additional portion of the loads are to be shed to control the frequency. If the implementation of the under-frequency load shedding schemes will not stop the frequency drop, then the islanded microgrid might be shut down by the under-frequency protection relays. In this figure, fmin3 shows the minimum limit at which the microgrid is shut down. Let's now have a look into the second case for the over-frequency event. In the figure, at the beginning, the frequency is controlled around the nominal value. However, some moments later, a number of loads are disconnected that will result in an increase in the frequency. Similar to the under-frequency event, the rate of change of the frequency in this case will be also dependent on the overall inherent and emulated inertia in the microgrid. If the frequency is controlled within the limits, then the islanded microgrid will be under the safe operation. However, if the frequency goes beyond a certain limit, fmax1, then a fraction of the loads are to be added to control the frequency. In a similar way, it is possible to control the frequency by disconnecting a number of the generating units at this point. If the addition of the loads or the disconnection of the generating units will not stop the increase in the frequency, then the islanded microgrids might be shut down by the over-frequency protection relays. In this figure, fmax2 represents the maximum limit at which the microgrid is shut down. Similar to the frequency control, various components are able to control the voltage in microgrids, such as diesel engine, battery, and loads. However, in a similar way, diesel engines and batteries are typically able to maintain the voltage within the limits during the islanded mode. However, the loads are only able to partially support the voltage. Also, the voltage problems during the grid-connected mode, such as transient voltage problem, voltage harmonics, and under or over voltage problems, would also exist in the islanded mode. As mentioned before, there are components in microgrids that are able to control both frequency and voltage. In particular, as diesel engines and batteries have good control over the frequency and voltage, there are also feasible components for the black start process. Note that the black start is needed when the islanded microgrid is shut down due to several reasons, like the problems with the frequency or voltage. The black start procedure can start with picking up the loads. In general, there are low-size loads, like household appliances, which can be picked up in the first step. Then, the larger size loads, like induction motors, can be picked up in the second step. Note that during both steps, the frequency temporarily decreases below the nominal value because these loads are added to the microgrid. Finally, some generating units, like solar photovoltaics, can be picked up that will lead to an increase in the frequency. Not only microgrids shall operate reliably during the grid-connected or islanded modes, but also they shall transfer safely and seamlessly between these two operating modes. In the microgrid, we show how the islanding process is done from the grid-connected at point 1 to the islanded mode. In other words, before point 1, the microgrid is operated in the grid-connected mode, while after this point, it will be operated in the islanded mode. It is assumed that in point 2, the microgrid starts to disconnect from the grid. Upon the disconnection from the grid, the frequency starts to decrease, and if it drops below a certain specific threshold, then the microgrid is shut down at point 3. However, if the components of microgrid, like batteries, or diesel engines would be able to control and recover the frequency to the rated value, then at point 4, the islanded process is successful. In this video, we started with the frequency control in microgrids during the islanded operation. Then we addressed several voltage problems which may occur in microgrids. It was discussed that some components, such as the batteries or diesel engines, are able to control both frequency and voltage in order to continue with the islanded operation for a certain period of time. Finally, we address the islanding process, which is crucial to ensure the safe transfer from the grid connected to the islanded mode. Well, in this week, we try to cover a wide range of relevant aspects related to the control in microgrids.